You know, there's this crazy moment in last Sunday's gospel. I feel like we read this kind of stuff and just sort of gloss over it. It doesn't really hit us. Like, Jesus multiplied food for people. John the Baptist had just been killed, and he hears about it, and obviously they're super close, and so he's really upset. He goes to be by himself, and this huge crowd of people follows him, and he's moved with pity for them, and so he spends some time with them. And it's getting late, and his apostles are like, hey, Jesus, look, all these people are out here for you, but you got to send them home, because we're way outside of town. There's no food out here. There's nothing for them to eat. And Jesus, he just does some weird stuff sometimes. He goes, give them some food yourselves. And the apostles are looking at each other like, what are you talking about? We don't have any food. And they kind of loop some other people in, and everyone sort of starts chipping in. And each person must have been like, well, this isn't enough. I mean, I have like a half a fish and two pieces of bread. You know, like, it's clearly not enough for everybody, but I guess I'll chip in anyway. And Jesus doesn't look at what they have and say, are you crazy? That's not enough. Well, why would you even bring this to me? No, he says, bring it here to me. And he takes what little they have to offer, and he blesses it, and he breaks it, and he tells them to go share it with the crowd. There's over 5,000 people out there. And, you know, the scripture doesn't say that they see it multiply before them, but they just know that he blessed it, and he broke it, and he gave this command. And so they go out there, they put it in baskets, and they just start going and handing it out. And what would it have been like? I can't even imagine, right? You're just thinking, I'm going to get like 5 people into the crowd. I'm going to run out, and I'm going to get attacked, you know? But they just keep reaching their hand back in and keep sharing, you know? And at the end of it, there's 12 baskets left over. And I think the lesson for us is not only to trust that he provides more than enough and that he provides, but to be willing to offer what we have, even if it's very little, to be able to just give everything we have, even if what we have is clearly not enough. Because when we give it to him, he does something amazing with it. Again, that faith to not necessarily see it multiply, but to believe that it's different than it was before we gave it to him, and that now something new can be done. And at the end of it, there's leftovers. Like, he over-provided. The first reading, all who are thirsty, come to the water. There's food for the hungry. There's drink for the thirsty. Come to me. Trust me. Give me what you have. Cooperate with me. I feel like the lesson there is relatively straightforward, but we see it as a story from the past rather than something he wants to do right now. In August of 2020, the Lord wants to take what little you and I have and do something amazing with it. Right now, in August of 2020, the Lord is planning to provide more than what we need. I needed that word this Sunday.